Breaking news out of Silicon Valley. Facebook has banned a number of prominent conspiracy theorists and alt-right figures from both its site and the Instagram platform, including Alex Jones and his media outlet InfoWars. NBC's Ben Collins joins me now from our New York newsroom. Ben, this is, I think, for those of us who've been following this story, why are they doing this now?
Well, it's a good question as to why they waited this long, but
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. So Alex Jones has been banned from Facebook for a long period of time, but now they banned him. They banned his like little underling, Paul Joseph Watson, who's a notorious anti-Muslim conspiracy theorist who tried to break off recently. They banned Laura Loomer. They've even banned Louis Farrakhan from platform for his anti-Semitism, which is That's always sort of been the what about from the right here is why not ban Louis Farrakhan if you're banning Alex Jones? So they banned both. So that's what's happening here on Instagram today. They are taking down what they call organized hate groups or, you know, hate against specific religions, specific like sexuality, things like that. This is sort of taking the lead of its parent company, Facebook, from a while back, which had a hard time enforcing this. And it's actually going a little bit further than Twitter. A lot of these people aren't banned from Twitter. And they are, in fact, banned from Instagram now.
So is this a decision that's based in, rooted in the policy that Facebook has had all the way along, or is this essentially a political decision?
It's complicated. It depends on how you want to view this, really. A lot of people on the right say this is censorship, to take people down, even though they are, you know, effectively over and over again railing against specific religions or people like that, like contributing to targeted harassment of sometimes private figures. But really what they're trying to do here is clamp down on the really bad stuff on their platform so they have fewer PR disasters. This is a company that has abetted, unfortunately, accidentally abetted genocide in Myanmar with Facebook. So they're trying to stop all the bad stuff on the platform from getting too big. And frankly, by the way, really quickly, Alex Jones, while banned from Facebook, was still on Instagram. And if you, we did some internal data on this. If you looked up Joe Biden, one of the top 20 posts on all of Facebook and Instagram in the last 3 days about Joe Biden came from Alex Jones's Instagram account. So that's gone now. That's just not there for him anymore.
Yeah, a very telling statistic. NBC's Ben Collins, thanks very much for the update. We appreciate it.